Umkhonto was Sizwe. Born in the early 60s as the ANC's military wing. It generally became known as MK, its translation meaning Spear of the Nation. And was essentially the third stage in the anti-apartheid struggle. Passive resistance had given rise to a civil disobedience campaign. But that all changed when Hendrik Verwoerd's government said it would use maximum force to silence any notion of a liberation movement.
You know, when the ANC was banned in 1960, and Madiba made the statement, it's then that we understood what he meant by saying the old chapter is closed, namely that now we are going to take up arms and defend our people.
There are many people who feel that it is useless and futile for us to continue talking peace and non-violence against a government whose reply is only savage attacks on an unarmed and defenseless people.
It may have been a military movement, but MK's ultimate goal was to force the apartheid regime to engage the ANC in peaceful negotiations. Nelson Mandela traveled across the continent, drumming up military support from African states. MK launched its first guerrilla attack in December 1961, targeting government installations and structural apartheid symbols. But its soldiers had much to learn.
I was caught in the very first action, you know, because we were ham-handed, we were very amateurish. I mean, the bomb, the so-called bomb, the explosive charge that I placed in a magistrate's court in Johannesburg, I mean, it was infantile. So, and the way we did the operation was very amateurish. And all our people who were involved will tell you, you know, we were total amateurs. I mean, the way some of our people, you know, when some of our people were instructed to go and learn how to make a bomb, what do? They went to libraries and read books, because we didn't have the know-how.
But soon after it began gathering momentum, 10 senior MK leaders, including Mandela, were imprisoned and charged with sabotage. The case came to be known as the Rivonia Trial, ending with the ANC and SACP's top brass being sentenced to life in prison. Leading liberation movements were forced underground, and some feared it was the end of Umkhonto we Sizwe. But the struggle continued. Following the Soweto uprising in June 1976, there was an exodus of young black men and women, a self-imposed exile in search of military training. Among that group was Ramaduku Maputa, who joined MK in Uganda.
I've learned the military combat work. I've learned the engineering, firearm, physical training, topography. Here inside the country, we did not have where to sit, where we can sit and rethink about how to, I mean, to deal with the enemy. But there, it was a good time and a good place where we can strategize in a military way to advance to the enemy.
We shall fight capitalism with all our might.
During this period, MK found a leader in SACP Secretary General Chris Hani, who became its chief of staff and energized the young combatants. The 80s saw a wave of MK attacks, generally targeting military points, but often catching civilians in the crossfire.
How are you?
Jesus!
How are you giving?
How far?
As the decade wore on, change began blowing across the country. Many political prisoners were being released. Shortly after Nelson Mandela walked free in February 1990, he visited MK camps across the continent.
Oh, the mood was electric, I can tell you. You know, having been born so many years ago, hearing of this giant called Nelson Mandela, whom no one else has seen. But it was, for us, you know, a big day to see this giant called Nelson Mandela. All of us wanted to see him. We unfortunately didn't have cameras.
By August 1990, MK operations had been suspended in preparation for the dismantling of apartheid. Many soldiers returned home to a hero's welcome. In 1994, as Nelson Mandela ascended to the presidency, it was time for MK to put down its arms, with many being integrated into the existing military to form the new South African National Defence Force. But there wasn't space for all of them. Hit by unemployment and poverty, some soldiers became disillusioned, resentment crept in. Many believe MK veterans were directly involved in a surge of violent crime, attacks often being carried out with military precision. It's an image that continues to haunt Umkhonto Sizwe's place in the new South Africa, despite its profound contribution to dismantling white minority rule.
Know more about your world. ENCA.com